Islam was trying to reform the chastity and modesty of the community, wasn't just saying we're here to reform woman.
Everyone.
Male and female.
Yes.
Both of them had to have an observance of that complete package known as hijab.
Yes.
If you look in the Quran, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him and his family, first begins with social hijab before physical. In Surah 24, verse 27 of the Holy Quran, Surah 24, I would say, in Surah 33, probably have the most verses in the Quran on that whole concept known as hijab. Surah 24, verse 27, if all the viewers at home go and read it, it was referring to social hijab. After that, Islam then said, let's talk about the men's hijab first. Many times we say women should be wearing their head covering and have a good hijab. It takes two to tango. The men are also staring at the woman. The men, if they lower the gaze, the men, if they show respect, then it's a different context altogether. Sometimes we're saying the woman's hijab is not right. Okay, the men are also to be warned about the way that they're looking at the woman, the way that they're moving with the woman. Quran says, Surah 24, verse 30, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُ فُرُوجَهُ. Quran says what? This is very important. Tell the believing men to lower their gaze and to protect their private parts. Protect your private parts, of course, from committing an act of adultery, for example. But lowering the gaze.
Yes.
Are you good at lowering your gaze? All of us. We try our hardest, but we're not angels. Let's admit this and be frank. I'm not sitting here in front of everybody to be someone who is an angel sitting or holier than thou. You come to the summer months living in Europe and America.
Yeah.
Lowering the gaze. I've seen people who may have lived in Iraq and Iran who say to you, you know, all of you youth in the West should lower your gaze. Come to us in America or come to us in London in the summer, 30, 35 degrees Celsius. I tell you, even that person who's mastered the whole religion will have a peak. God told us.
Well, the first look is halal, saying.
First look is halal, but it doesn't mean you just turn around and start looking all the way like this. I remember one person said, he said, Sayyidina, first looks halal. So I looked at her, I looked at her, I looked at her, I looked at her, I looked at her across the road. No. You try your hardest, first look, and then try and put the eyes down really quickly. And is it easy? It's not easy at all. Even in the Middle East, there are certain Middle East countries. It's not easy at all. Naturally, when a person thinks that the eye can commit zina, the eye can commit
zina.
A person says, how can the eye commit zina?
How?
The eye can also commit adultery.
Uh-huh.
The Prophet Jesus and the Prophet Muhammad in the Bible and in the Quran both have spoken about the eye can commit adultery. And this verse was revealed that one cousin of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon his family, this beautiful lady walked past. He kept looking, 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 followed her, followed her, followed her until he banged his head. And the Prophet then asked him, why did you bang your head? What happened? Oh, this, that. And then he admitted. Quran said, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ what? قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُضُّ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. This brings about tazkiyah.
Yes.
It brings about a purification of the soul. And we know in the Quran, Allah says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّاهَا. Successful is the one who's able to purify his soul. Because the soul wants that desire. The soul doesn't care. Your soul, you know, your nafs is telling you, listen, just go and do what you have to do. Don't think twice about it. After that, and this is where we bring the word khimar in.
Mm-hmm.
Quran, after telling the men, because it knew men is most of the trouble, Quran after that said, وَقُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَغْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِنَّ وَيَحْفَضْنَ فُرُوجَهُنَّ. Tell the believing woman to also lower their gaze. As in, don't think that us men are, you know, the craziest animals out there. There are some.